March 30th, 1993. Darryl Sutter was in the midst of leading the Chicago Blackhawks to a conference best record in his first season as head coach. He and his wife Wanda were also preparing for the birth of their third child. That day, Darryl's life changed forever, both personally and professionally. His son Chris was born with Down syndrome and fighting for his life.
Brent called and he said, "Mom, I have to tell you something. Darryl Wanda had a baby boy today." And I started to cry. I said, "Tell me what's the matter?"
It was a tough time, tough couple of weeks. I'd usually go from the game if we were playing, and I'd go and I'd just stay in the hospital. I still remember I could put my finger into the unit he was in, and he'd hold my finger, and I'd tell him just to hang on.
That's something that no new mother should be told, that you're going to outlive your child. It was really difficult.
They felt we should give Chris up, and it didn't take more than about half a second to tell that doctor what his job was.
With Chris's condition at the forefront, Darryl returned to the Hawks bench and led his team to the conference final.
For Steve Smith, long shot to a screen, tip, they score!
But despite his success on the ice, Sutter's priorities had changed. For the first time in his life, he decided to walk away from hockey, to focus solely on family.
I told him that spring that there was a good chance of it, you know, that I wasn't going to come back.
For the Sutters, dealing with Down syndrome was something foreign. It became obvious that the family had learned as much from Chris as he was learning from them.
I think it really, really woke us up.
It changes your aspect and your perspective on the way you look at things.
It added a whole new dynamic to our family and more importantly to Darryl and Wanda's family.
I think he's taught a lot of the Sutters to be happy with what they have and what they've got.
Four years had passed since he was told his son didn't have long to live. With Chris proving doctors wrong and showing clear progress, Darryl made his next major decision.
Watching the playoffs, you could tell he'd start to pace, and you knew he just was missing it then.
I remember telling Wanda that I was sort of thinking about it, if we thought Chris was in a good place.
When San Jose then called him, he was ready to go.
After stints in San Jose and Calgary, Sutter landed in LA and quickly reached the pinnacle of his sport. Despite the changes, one thing remained constant. His son was always right by his side.
The other game, we're only going on ice for about 20 minutes.
20 minutes?
About that, yeah. He brings that spirit or that energy to the locker room.
We're pretty close to him just because of that, because he lightens up the room pretty much every time she steps in, and you know, the guys are joking around with him all the time.
I always do that, every time, brother.
Yeah. I try to. Doesn't always work, but I try to.
Really?
Yeah.
Can you hug me before I leave?
Yeah. Of course.
Thanks, buddy.
It chokes you up because I think he's more invested than even, like, sometimes even Dad. Like, those guys are his heroes.
Darryl always calls Chris his magic. Like, Chris, if we're at the farm and Kings have lost a couple games, Darryl always says, "Chris, we need a little of your magic."
You know, I'll take Chris in there the next morning, and he'll have a little pep talk and gets everybody going.
So when we come and they win, it's like, there it is, there's that magic.
Come up, buddy.
Yeah, buddy.
Wait, just you out.
Oh, I'm just getting myself ready, Chris. Can you help me out?
This is Matt Green, assistant captain.
Hey, Chris, how you doing, bud?
Good. Good luck.
Thanks, buddy.
It's your take off, right?
Can't be doing that.
I'll see you soon.
All right, see you soon.
Enjoy yourself, Gabrick.
Which brings us to his proudest moment. A moment only a select few have ever experienced.
If I lifted a cup over my head, it was so special to me.
That's my best memory of that whole night, was when see Chris get it.
It was priceless. I mean, we laughed so hard and cried. It was pretty cool for him.
Tears, honestly. He was the happiest kid on the planet that night.
Pretty emotional, yep. I don't know if I could even describe it in words. It was pretty emotional. I'm very, very proud of him, yeah.
Moments after raising the Stanley Cup, Chris was in for another thrill.
I think the whole world should meet the guy who's with us right now, so why don't you tell us who we're with right now, and he's special to both of us, I know. Why don't you introduce our buddy?
That's Chris Sutter. That's Darryl's son, and he feels like a brother to me.
It seems like you really enjoyed it, and it warms my heart up, too, because, you know, we're very close, and, you know, I'd like to see him be happy and excited.
21 years ago, Darryl Sutter refused to give up on his newborn son. Over two decades later, that same child has redefined an entire family's concept of what being a successful Sutter truly means.
Heck, he's the only kid who ever graduated who got a standing ovation from 600 students. So that for sure is number one, for sure, not even close. Is all the medical stuff, he jumped over those hurdles and blew them away 15 years ago.